Hey there, it's Kristen with K Design Co. And today I'm going to share a really quick tutorial on how to create a redirect for your Showit site. So there's actually two methods that you can do this. I'm going to show you both. The first one I'm going to do, you can actually do directly inside of Showit. So the first thing you're going to do is go to your main Showit dashboard and then open up your site settings. So you're going to click site settings. And then if your site is already published, you should have a domain connected to that. So what you're going to do is go in here and click edit under custom domain. And then there's this little sneaky little gear button over here that you've probably missed before. But all you have to do is click that gear. And then now you're going to be shown this redirect panel. So essentially what you're doing when you're creating a redirect is you are taking an existing site page or link that you might have out there in the world, and you want that link to point to a different page. So use case for this would be you updated the URL, maybe for SEO reasons, and or you're just changing the name of your services. So you want that new link to reflect those changes. Now, for SEO purposes, redirects are also great because it passes on the link juice or authority that that page may have built up over time. So you don't want all of those old links going to, say, a 404 page. Instead, you want to pass that link juice onto the new page, and you want your visitors to have a seamless experience who may have been visiting the old link. So all you're going to do to set up this redirect is on the left-hand side is you're going to put the slug of the old page. So maybe that's old page. There's no spaces allowed in your slug. So if you have a space in the page name, it would be translated into a hyphen or a one word slug would just be the word. And then over here on the right, you're going to new your new page slug. So you can do it like this, and then all you have to do is hit add and then close. And then once you publish your changes over here, now that new redirect should be in place. Okay, so this is how to do it inside of Showit. But what if you want to do it through your WordPress dashboard, especially for sites that have blogs, or a lot of other custom post types. This is a great way to manage redirects and can also be done somewhat automatically using the use of a free plugin. So if you are in your WordPress dashboard, go over here to your plugin section, and we're going to add a new plugin, and you're going to type in redirection. So install this one right here. So this one is 2 million active installations. It's a great, super simple, no frills plugin. It just works. It's the one that I use for my own site and my client sites. This is a test site, so that's why I'm installing it now from afresh. So when you install it, then it's going to ask you to do a quick setup. So by default, it can kind of pull in some basic settings. So I try not to mess too much with this. Essentially, it's just telling you how it kind of works and what the features are. So you can go ahead and hit start setup. If you want for it to monitor if you change slugs, like with your posts or your pages, and then automatically create a redirect for you if you decide to change it. Let's say you publish a blog post, you know, a few months ago, and you decide you want to change the title and you want that URL to also reflect that. So if you do go in and update the URL for your post, it will automatically create a redirect for you from the old one to the new one. So if you want that to do that for you automatically, you could check this box. This is also a good box to check if you want to know if you have some old links out there that maybe have not gotten redirects and people are going to 404 pages. So you can check those depending on what kind of settings you want. I'm just going to leave them unchecked for now, though. And then over here, we have another question that's asking you if you want to import any existing redirects that you may have. So you can, again, select that if you want. Otherwise, you can just go ahead and go back. So now it's going to do a little bit of testing that should come back good for you. And then if it does not, you can always click here and kind of do some troubleshooting, but hopefully it should be all good to continue. Just say finish setup. It should just take just a couple of minutes. And then once it is ready, hit continue, ready to begin. Okay, so now this is the main dashboard of the plugin. It can be found under tools in WordPress and then redirection. And so when you come here, right now there's nothing to display because we have no redirects, but you can easily add a new redirect. And so how you can do that is straight from the screen. It's right here. So the source URL is the relative URL that you want to redirect from. So this is everything that would come after the slash of your main domain. So like kdesign.co/branding or kdesign.co/web design. So if I wanted to make a redirect for one of those pages, then I would just click in here and let's go ahead. I used to have my URL at this address and now I've changed it to just be branding. So this would be a good example or use case for this. So you can also change if you want it to ignore certain things, but usually I just leave this to be exact match. And then the target URL is actually where you need to do a full URL, not the relative URL. And then that is exactly how it's going to point. So brand style 2/branding and then add redirect. And then you'll see it comes up right here in this list. And so this list will get added to over time as you add redirects, or if you've set up the auto create redirect for post and page URL changes. Otherwise, you'll be able to see here from this main dashboard how many times that redirect has been hit, which means how many times somebody tried to view this page from maybe an old link, and then they actually got sent to this link. So you can check the redirect here, which is kind of a handy tool. And so this will let you know if this was actually in place. So this one actually isn't working because I'm just working on a test site, but that also does bring up a good point. You can't redirect a page from another domain to your domain. You can't like hijack somebody else's traffic. All of the redirects that you make, they have to be within your own domain. So that's why this URL has to be relative versus a absolute URL path. So other quick things to mention up here, you have kind of a log. So again, you could see how many 404s people are encountering if they are encountering those. So this would be a good place to check, you know, are people ending up at a page that you don't want them to be. And then if they are, you can create a redirect from that. So that's a pretty handy tool. I don't actually usually mess around much with these other things. You can also create groupings of redirects if you want to kind of help organize things. But at its core, this is kind of the base way to set up redirects. So hopefully this was helpful. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments. Thanks.